Hello, in this video, we're gonna look into an example of mixing chamber. In the last one, we're talking about the governing equation in terms of mass and energy conservation for mixing chamber. So here we have an actual example for it. So they have this set of steam is at 0.2 megapascal and 300. Degrees Celsius that comes in and mix with this cold water, and it's 20 degrees Celsius and 0.2 megapascal. Huh? Then you produce this 20 kilogram per second. That's going to be our mass flow rate. So M3 dot of 20 kilogram per second, and it's saturated liquid. And the pressure is 0.2 megapascal. And we were asked to find what's the required steam and cold water flow rate. So they want us to find what's M1, what's the mass flow rate of the steam, and what will be the mass flow rate for this cold water. Okay, so by looking at this example, you know it's a mixing chamber. So we immediately go to our mass and energy conservation equation for two inlets and one outlet. Mass conservation will be M1 dot plus M2 dot equal to M3 dot. Then our energy equation, we discussed in the last video. If you haven't seen it, make sure you get back to that. Will be M1 dot H1, that's going to be the enthalpy here, H2 plus M2 dot H2 equals M3 dot H3. So those are the two equations. Now let's think about it. Can we figure out our H3 from this? We know it's a saturated liquid. We know the pressure is 0.2. So we go to our steam table. We go to our table A5 at 0.2 megapascal. And H3 should be equal to HF because it's saturated liquid at 0.2 megapascal. So we're at table A5 at 0.2, which means 200 kilopascal, and we are reading HF. So it's this value, 504.75. Sorry, that's just disappeared. So it's 504.71. That's kilojoule per kilogram. That's our H3. So H3 is known now. So is there any way we can find H1 and H2, right? So let's go ahead and solve H1. H1, for the steam, we also know two properties. We know the temperature, and we also know the pressure. So at T1 at 300, P1 at 0.2 megapascal. We want to first find out what region it belongs. Is that superheated or not? So we need to find the T saturated temperature at 0.2 megapascal. In order to do so, we're going to go to our pressure table for saturated liquid. So at 0.2 megapascal, we can actually already, okay, right here, right? 0.2 is 200 kilopascal, and the saturated temperature is 120.21 degrees Celsius. And this given temperature is 300 degrees Celsius, way greater than the saturated temperature. That gives us reason to believe this is going to be superheated vapor. So if it's a superheated vapor, in order to find our H1, we need to go to A6. So going back to steam table, look at table A6. At 0.2 megapascal and 300 degrees Celsius, right? Then we're looking at our H value. So H value here is equal to 3072.1. That's our H1 kilojoule per kilogram. So knowing that, we're going to look for our H2, right? So the next step is, let's go ahead and label this. This is our map. This we figure out H3, and now we figure out H1. Now it's time to find out what H2 will be. H2, we also know two properties. T2 is 20, and pressure is 0.2. Well, we already know this T2, 20 degree, is way less than this saturated temperature we found out from previously. It's 120.21 at this the same pressure, right? 0.2 megapascal. That tells us this is going to be a compressed liquid or subcooled liquid. So if it is a compressed liquid, we normally go to the compressed liquid table. That's table A7. But we run into a dilemma. The lowest pressure they have there is 5 megapascal, and our pressure is 0.2. So remember when we encounter this, what do we normally have to do? We have to approximate, because this is compressed liquid. So we're going to find our H2 approximate using saturated liquid at the same temperature, 20 degrees Celsius. That's how we approximate. Then let's go to our temperature table. So from here, we're gonna go to table A4. A4 is our saturated liquid with temperature. So table A4, it's at 20 degree, and we are trying to find HF, so it will be this value. So our HF value is going to be 83.915 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, so that's our H2. So far what we have done is we look at this governing equation, figure out the mass and the energy conservation. And since each state, we know two properties, we find their individual enthalpy, H3, H1, and H2. Now we're ready to put those enthalpy back to those equations. So step 5, we'll have mass flow rate plus M2 equals M3 dot. And do we know the M3 dot? It's 20, right? 20 kilogram per second. Then the second equation, we will have M1 dot times H1 H1 is 3072.1 plus M2 dot times H2. H2 is 83.915 M2 dot. Then we have M3 dot that's given as 20. Then times our H3. H3 is 504.71. Okay, so we have those two equations. It's a linear systematic equation. And we can put into our calculator to set up matrix or whatever you decide to do. Then you can get the answer for this mass flow rate. Okay, so I'm going to ignore that calculation. I'm going to look at this, and that shows us the M1 is going to be 2.82 and M2 dot is going to be 17.8. That's going to be our answer. And they will have mass flow rate unit, which is kilogram per second, kilogram per second. All right. So that's the end of this mixing chamber example, and hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time. Bye.